Systems of differential equations. In the previous videos, we covered the various ways that differential equations were classified. Another classification of differential equations depends on the number of unknown functions that are involved. If there is a single function to be determined, then one equation is sufficient. However, if there are two or more unknown functions, then a system of equations is required. Up to this point, we have been discussing single differential equations containing one unknown function. But often, in theory, as well as in many applications, we must deal with systems of differential equations. A system of ordinary differential equations is two or more equations involving the derivatives of two or more unknown functions of a single independent variable. For example, if x of t and y of t denote dependent variables, and t denotes the independent variable, then a system of two first-order differential equations is given by the following expressions. A solution of this system is a pair of differential functions that satisfies each equation in the system on some common interval I. This is analogous to systems of linear equations from your studies of algebra. Recall that the goal was to find an ordered pair, x and y, that would satisfy both equations. In the case of a system of differential equations, we're actually looking for two functions that would satisfy both differential equations. Systems of differential equations will be discussed in greater detail in a much later video. For now, this video will illustrate how to identify and verify a solution to the system of differential equations. Let's go over a couple of examples to illustrate how to verify the solutions of a system of differential equations. Verify that the indicated pair of functions is a solution of the given system of differential equations on the interval negative infinity to positive infinity, or all real numbers. The system of differential equations is the derivative of x with respect to t equals x plus 3y, and the derivative of y with respect to t equals 5x plus 3y. The solutions to verify are x equals e raised to the power of negative 2t plus 3 times e raised to the power of 6t, and y equals negative e raised to the power of negative 2t plus 5 times e raised to the power of 6t. Notice that we have two dependent variables, specifically x and y, both of which contain a single independent variable, in this case, t. The procedure to verify a system of differential equations is very similar to the way that you verified ordinary differential equations. It is just a matter of finding all the required derivatives and substituting them, along with the functions, into the system of differential equations, making sure that the left and right-hand side of each equation match. In this example, we need to find the derivative of x with respect to time. So we go ahead and apply the chain rule to the first function. Taking the derivative term by term results in the following expression for the derivative. Now let's find the derivative of y with respect to t. Similar to the previous derivative, we need to find the derivative term by term and apply the chain rule. This results in the following expression. Having found the derivative, we go ahead and verify that both the left and right-hand side of each differential equation matches when we substitute the derivative and functions. Let's verify the first differential equation. We start by replacing the left side with the derivative, and replace the right side with the functions x and y, as follows. Then, it is just a matter of simplifying the expressions, so we go ahead and distribute the constant on the right side. Then we collect like terms. In the end, we see that both sides of the equation match. Now we need to do the same for the second differential equation. So we go ahead and substitute the derivative and the functions with the respective expressions. Then we go ahead and distribute the constants on the right side of the equation. And finally, we collect like terms. In the end, we see that both sides also match. Since these functions are solutions to both differential equations, we conclude that these two functions are indeed solutions to the system of differential equations. The process is very similar to the way we verified solutions to differential equations. In this case, we need to verify all the equations within the system. Alright, let's go over the final example. The system of differential equations is the second derivative of x with respect to t equals 4y plus e raised to the power of t, and the second derivative of y with respect to t equals 4x minus e raised to the power of t. The solutions to verify are x equals cosine of 2t plus sine of 2t plus 1/5 times e raised to the power of t, and y equals negative cosine of 2t minus sine of 2t minus 1/5 times e raised to the power of t. Notice that we once again have two dependent variables, in this case x and y, both of which contain the independent variable t. Alright, similar to the first example, let's first find the derivatives of the dependent variables with respect to t. Notice that we need to find the second derivative of each function, so let's go ahead and find the first derivative of x with respect to t. Taking the derivative term by term along with the chain rule, we obtain the following expression. Next, let's take the derivative once more. Taking the derivative a second time results in the following expression. Next, let's do the same and find the second derivative of y with respect to t. Taking the derivative term by term and applying the chain rule, we obtain the following expression. Then we once again take the derivative with respect to t. Doing that, we obtain the following expression for the second derivative. Now it's just a matter of substituting the second derivatives along with the functions and verify that they satisfy the system of differential equations. Let's verify the first differential equation by substituting these expressions and verifying that the left and right-hand side of the equation match. Substituting the expressions, we obtain the following. Then we go ahead and distribute the constant on the right side of the equation. From here, we go ahead and collect like terms. In the end, we see that both sides of the equation match. Now we need to verify the second differential equation. So we go ahead and substitute the following expressions into the differential equation. Then we go ahead and distribute the constant on the right side of the equation. From here, we collect like terms. In the end, we see that both sides of the equation match. Since these functions are solutions to both differential equations, we conclude that these two functions are indeed solutions to the system of differential equations. Alright, in our next video, we will start discussing initial value problems, also known as IVPs.